Hey kids, it's Mr. Mendoza,
and it's time for art.
Today we are drawing an eagle. Go ahead and pause and go back whenever you want.
All right, let's get started on that eagle. So once again, I got a tracing shape here, and this is just kind of a lid. Make sure anytime you get a lid, make sure it's clean. Not wet or not dirty, so that way you don't mark up your paper and have to start over. So really quick, hold it down tight. Go around the edges. All right. There we go. The first thing I want to do is kind of bring down a line like this. Then I want to bring down another line like here. Let's keep them a little bit curved. This one on this side's a little longer than that side. The face is going to be facing that way, so the beak will be over here. Okay, very nice. Then really lightly, kind of cut this circle in the middle so we can kind of measure. And a little above this line, I want to start a curve. They kind of got a big hook nose. It's not pointy like another bird. It's a big hook nose. Okay, then I'm going to curve that up. Right, to about there. See how these lines almost touch? Good job. Before we forget, let's put the little eye in. We'll keep it light for now. Let's do the bottom of the beak here. All right, pretty good. Okay, so from here, what I want to do is put the little nostril so our bird can breathe. A little dot right here. Okay, next I want to kind of frame this beak, so we're gonna bring it into the circle. We'll darken this line, kind of make like a little rounded point going that way. Then what I want to do is, now that we don't need the bottom of this circle anymore, we can erase that. Hopefully I did a good job of keeping it light. I could have done a better job keeping it light, but sometimes tracing, you gotta go a little darker than you want. Just to, you know, takes practice. Okay, so what I want to do is add some, well, let's get this eye dark first, and then we'll add some texture. Feathers, and then we'll give them kind of a heavy brow, a real serious brow. They kind of look like they're angry. Just really focused bird. There we go. All right, so I'm gonna start up here. I'm gonna start with this kind of U shape. Then I'm gonna give it two buddies, maybe like a W. The pattern keeps going. So this one in the center. See that? We can even bring this over here. And I'm gonna kind of give some gaps. Just to give the idea that this bird has feathers, but we don't need to do all the feathers, it'll take forever. Then I'm gonna start framing out the bottom of this. Okay, I can darken that in now. Notice I kept those little feathers light so I can go back and erase. Now that line, I don't need that line anymore. I'm gonna take away that. That's what's good about your layout lines or your work lines. If you keep them light, this last step I always do where we get to erase some of those lines we made, it's a lot easier. Pencil went flying. All right, so one of the last steps here, I'm gonna try to give this bird a more defined head, so it's a little straighter in the front. All right. There we go. working some of these other lines. Let's see, maybe a few feathers here. Looks pretty good. And maybe a little line here. Not bad. Oh, I see something else we can erase there. All right. There we go. Pretty much done, and there's our eagle. Our intermediate eagle here, so I already got the circle drawn. Kind of eyeball halfway. And a little bit this way. I'm gonna keep it light so you can erase it later. Notice that I'm way back here. Right. The beak's gonna be on this side, so the same way as this, the easy. I'm gonna curve this down from here. Pay attention to the bottom here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this top of the beak kind of above this level and drag it kind of, there we go, to the bottom of the head shape. All right, then I'm gonna make another line here, kind of eyeball between here and here, the middle. Draw a little line. And right about here, I'm gonna do a dot for the eye. Then I'm thinking I'm gonna drag this curve in, and I wanna make this a little bit thicker. That's where the light drawing comes in handy, see? Okay, then I'm gonna drag from like right about here, the bottom of the beak. Okay, looking good. Now I'm gonna think about, let's do the brow. These birds kind of always look angry or very serious. Put an eyebrow and then draw the circle around. Notice that it chops off the top. All right, let's put a nostril so our bird can breathe. I can line up with that line across, see that? Okay. Now start dragging the mouth in. So we've got the eye now, we're gonna drag this a little past it, see? Alright, now the circle top, I'm gonna make this a little more square up here. So we'll start fixing this beak. I'm gonna give it a little ridge. Erase your lines as you go. Okay, so for this one, I want to make just a few little feather lines, like a showed you in the easy version, so if you didn't see it, it's basically like a U-shape and then kind of a little trio. But for the back of the head, I just want to add a little bit of like streaks coming out. And get to the bottom here, we can kind of frame the top of the head with some of those U-shapes. It can be different lengths and thicknesses. There you go. Even some of these streaks, kind of round them off. Then what I want to do is just kind of frame around the eye. Let's get rid of some of those work lines. Remember, if you don't have a big old paintbrush, just go quickly with your hand. Try to be soft and not smudge your art. Okay, last steps here. I'm going to kind of start darkening some things in, and we'll be done in a sec. So what I want to do is hold my pencil kind of sideways and gently some shading around that eye. It's almost like an oval shape. Put a little bit under here. And if you want, you can put some under some of the feathers here and there. Just give a little idea of texture. All right, so I'm gonna start darkening some of these things up. Okay, much better. As you can see, while I was shading, added some little streak lines in here, shaped up some of the feathers, added some details to the beak and around the eye, even shaded inside the eye. So looking pretty good. So awesome, we're gonna move on to the advanced and we'll kind of go over some of this again. Hey! All right, just like the previous versions, if you watched them, I started by dividing up this shape. So I'm gonna kind of gently with light lines. So you notice how I'm scooted way back on this pencil here. Lay down a couple of light lines. Remember, these are designed to be erased later. So just keep them very light. Try to make sure you're slicing this little pizza real even. Or if you want to think about it as a pie, it could be a pie too. All right. Now what I'm gonna do next is kind of drag this line out just for the beak of the eagle. Just a little bit. Remember, if we make it too long, we can erase it later. What I want to do here is I'm going to look at the center line I made and the edge of the circle and try to eyeball or guess which part is the center, because I want to put another line here to divide. I know it's a lot of crisscrossing, a lot of guesswork. Okay, so down here, I'm going to kind of go halfway from top to bottom. Make a little mark here. Maybe drag another line out. All right. Okay, I think we're pretty good set up to get started. All right, here we go. Let's get rid of some of that fuzz happening there. All right, so first thing I want to do is kind of figure out how I want that beak. So what I'm thinking is let's go ahead and get that eye going. So I'm going to put a little dot here. We made that little crisscross happen. Then I'm thinking a little bit above this line here, the eye line, just a little bit above. I'm gonna start the curve. So I'm gonna kind of come round it out like an oval, or honestly like a rounded square like we talked about back in the other video. So I'm gonna drag this kind of hook nose happening here for the beak. Big strong nose. Let's go a little past that line. All right, so notice this line here. I'm gonna carefully kind of drag it up. And lightly pull this line a little past that eye. Okay. So here's a detail of the beak of a realistic eagle. They kind of have this like bump here. Almost like a bat wing, see that? And then it kind of curves down. There we go. All right, so the next thing I want to do is bring that bottom beak in. And I actually want to extend this line here. Kind of help me get the neck and the bottom beak going. So what I'm going to do is drag that beak from a little bit under here. So we see a little bit of the edge, and it's going to get thicker. And I'm gonna curve it past this line. Then I'm gonna come back to the shape a little like this. There we go. Remember, we're gonna erase some of those things later, so keep it light. I'm gonna put the back of the head here. All right, not bad, looking good. Now my bird, he needs to breathe, or she needs to breathe. I'm gonna put a little nostril here, kind of line it up with the eye. Long little oval dot. And darken that in now so we don't have to worry about it later. Alright, looking good. So next thing I want to do is start putting the brow here. They kind of have like an angry, tough brow. They always look a little grumpy or serious. I'm going to drag a little eyebrow here. I'm going to come close to this dot but curve it up. All right, and right now I'm just gonna get that circle going. All right. This is where the light lines come in handy. You're gonna erase things I don't like. Okay, now I'm kinda gonna frame this beak. So I'm not gonna use that line from the circle, but I'm gonna have like this line here kind of curve, and around the beak here they got like a little thin little like lips. Then come back to the circle's edge and kind of make an angle down there. Straighten that out a little bit. I don't know if I like that. All right. And what I'm gonna do here is start darkening in that line. Okay, I'm gonna just darken in this beak while I'm at it. My guidelines kind of tell me where to go, and you get to choose which ones you want to use. So some of them, you know, you can tell there's an outer line here. I didn't use that, so I'm gonna get rid of that. And you can get rid of this stuff now, or you can wait to the end and kind of get some of them gone. Depends on how you like to work. Sometimes I'm all over the place. Alright, so I'm gonna put some places where the shadow comes. They have a beak that's sharp as a knife, so I'm gonna kind of put some edges here. A shading to show that sharpness. Just get some shading going really quick. Okay, so now what I'm gonna start doing is looking at the whole picture, erasing. I'm gonna start putting some texture line for the feathers. In the earlier versions, I showed a very cartoony way of how to do like feathers. They almost look like fish scales in a way. But eagles really have these long, like pointy feathers. So I'm going to use line and show some streaks and ways that we can kind of give the idea of texture for the eagle. So I'm going to kind of start up here. Okay, so I laid out some lines here to kind of give some texture. And what I'm going to do next is kind of show you here, put some long little lines here for the beard. There's little sharp long feathers hanging down from their chin. And everything kind of has a flow, it's flowing out. Everything is kind of flowing back from that beak on the eagle head. Okay, so I took some time to kind of clean that up. And I'm kind of going to finish here with some more feather texture. Using a thicker line, kind of give some depth. Don't want to overdo it with too many lines. frame the neck area here, just adding a couple shapes. All right, let's add a little shading. Let's add a little shading around the eye too to give it some more texture. The shading under the beak. Remember we talked about all the flow coming out of the head from the beak? They almost kind of have like a little eyeliner around their eye. So this little dark area here, I'm just going to darken that in. We're almost done. Let's add a bit of shading in there too. Use my shading tool to add some more. I'm gonna use my shading tool just to add a few lighter lines here and there. You can still get the same effect with your pencil if you're very light. Looks pretty good, and I think we're done. Remember, practice your light drawing, it helps. And remember, in certain cases, we can leave some of those work lines, but for this one, it didn't make sense to have a crisscross going through the head. If your drawing doesn't look like mine and you want to keep trying, keep trying. Art's one of those things where you don't have to nail it the first time, so go ahead and try it again. And I know in my videos, I just do one drawing on a page, but if you want to try to draw it smaller, you got plenty of space around this picture to do that. All right, guys, it was fun arguing with you, and I'll see you later. All right, guys, it was fun arguing with you, as always. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe so you can see my upcoming videos. Keep practicing your drawing skills. Until next time.